Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce today's guest. This is the star of the Abroad in Japan YouTube channel, the podcast wizard, the Kent Master. You're a legend of Kent?
A legend of Kent, yeah.
He's the Karage King of Sendai. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chris Broad.
Yo, how you doing, guys? Where are you watching from? Let me know. How are you watching? Where are you watching?
Let's go.
There's a lot of questions there. So where are you watching from? Who are you watching with? What are you eating?
No drip today, Chris. What do you mean no drip? There's plenty of drip here. I didn't bring my hat, though. I should have brought a hat.
I got a Pokemon hat if you need it.
Yep. There's Pokemon hat.
Pokemon Chris coming at you. Rival Chris Broad.
I'm watching from New York from work. Get back to work. How dare you have fun in a workplace? Oh, what's
there
this?
There you go.
Is this a Pokemon hat?
Yeah, it's this trainer's hat. And also, if you desire, here's a scarf.
Oh, yeah.
If you need that.
Let's wear a scarf.
That's what we do here.
It's only 500 fucking degrees outside.
Yeah, but it's cold in the office. So where we're broadcasting from, I have the AC.
Look at that.
Oh, look at you. Nice and proper.
More fucking drip than the River Thames. Bring it on.
All right, so the first thing we're going to do, Chris, just to get this out of the way, I need to know how many people we have watching. It's an important check of one thing. Okay, we got about 1,000, which is great. Because the first thing we're going to do is...
About 1,000? No, it's 994 viewers.
It's about 1,000.
I don't get out of bed for less than 1,000 viewers. So how does this work, then? Give me the rundown.
All right, so basically, you can see up right here, there's the counter of how many people are registering to play.
Jesus, a lot of people.
All they have to do is hit exclamation play from their... point of view.
Right.
This one will be special. The winning person of this particular race will have their character or avatar drawn by Chris. Based on their username.
Based on their username?
Yeah, so...
What if we get someone like Mr. Dickhead?
Then you gotta draw Mr. Dickhead.
Right. Alright, so the winner of the marble race was called UTLR, which was an acronym, which I determined to be Ultimate Trippy Lame Rocket.
Ultimate Trippy Lame Rocket.
I just realized I need a L on there.
Ultimate Trippy Lame Rocket.
There's Greenland. Greenland. There's the Trippy Man. There's Jeff Bezos. There's the Lame Rocket.
There's the Lame Rocket.
But it's still the Ultimate Rocket because it can go into space. It can go past the Kármán line, 100 kilometers.
So it counts. It counts as a space trip.
It does.
There you go.
Ultimate Trippy, Lame Rocket, fucking get in.
There you
Best drawing ever.
Best drawing ever?
Give me a raise.
A raise?
Yeah.
I have to tell people I'm paying you to be here?
Puffy!
So, let's see. There's lots of people. Who has the better facial hair, Chris or Pete? I think it's a no contest. I look homeless.
It looks good. You look like Bradley Cooper and Kevin Rudd had a child.
Paul Rudd, I think you mean to say. Kevin Rudd. Kevin Rudd is a homeless man.
He was the Prime Minister of Australia, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, Paul Rudd, Bradley Cooper, and Steve Martin. If they had a kid, it would be this man right here. So what is Jackbox TV?
So Jackbox is, you're going to use this phone, and there's going to be some questions that are going to appear on the screen.
Right.
And there are 8 people, and the rest of the people can play in the audience.
I don't really know.
But you always drive.
Yeah, but nobody knows how a car works. Well, I broke down once because I didn't put enough fuel in it.
That's true. You are probably not the person to ask.
We use cars every day, but nobody knows how it works. I think I got it right, though. I think I got this one right.
Those who got cowpox did not get smallpox. The guy was from Gloucestershire. That's
Gloucestershire.
Right.
Gloucestershire.
A lot of people say that I look very similar to Leon Kennedy. I'll let you be the judge.
No.
One guy said that.
Something's not right.
Yeah, no shit, something's not right.
Something's not right.
Investigate this store.
This right here, little ice cream, look at it. It's herb ice cream.
What?
Herbs heal you. It's a little throwback to teach you about the healing.
You say herbs?
What do you call them, herbs?
Herbs.
Herbs. Herbs. 11 herbs and spices. Herbs.
Herbs. Herbs. There's a lot of inventory here, haven't they?
Yeah, that's what we do in America.
It's quite well stocked.
Pizzas?
We say petrol station.
Petrol station. This is a gas station.
Gas station.
And we have lots of cereals that we keep.
All right, so.
Yo-yo-hoo!
Holy yet! Thank you for the gift subs to Geo787 and
Wait. I heard a creepy noise.
I'm just trying to... fuck me! You scared me to death. What are you doing? I think what you're asking for costs at least $4 billion.
It doesn't cost $4 billion.
To have a fully destructible environment?
It's just Capcom being a little bit lazy. I was outside Capcom's office today eating a burger.
Did you tell them you think their game sucks?
Well, I haven't played it. Now I'm going to go back and do it tomorrow. Near Shake Shack, so kill two birds with one stone. Oh, a note. September 25th.
Mm.
Returning the station into a temporary shelter due to the massive sudden outbreak. All police personnel have been instructed to make the safety of the citizens their top priority. You try to accommodate as many of them as possible.
Wow.
Holy crap. September 25th.
Addendum.
Is that a word?
Yeah. In addition, addendum. It's like, oh, I forgot to write.
remember the old, again, remember my strategy?
Yep, blow before they show.
That sounds horrible.
Not what I wanted to say.
Why did it not kill him?
You killed the window!
I think I know when I can run through some steam. Okay, maybe. What's in here, though?
I think there's a...
No!
Oh, you walked into the heat again and it scared you. He's dead. They put him in there because he was dead. If you read your addendums, you blew his head off. And his ass.
Now, we've got the C4 here, but we've got no detonators.
Yeah, that's going to take a bit.
I'm not a physicist, but I'm wagering that rocket plus C4 equals... Fuck all. I must say, pistols are disgustingly ineffective.
Well, when you miss, it tends to do zero damage. Oh. Alright, so that was Resident Evil 2, Chris. Let's give him a big round of applause.
How did I do on a scale of 1 to 10, guys?
You like rating things. Chris and Pete, what's your go-to fast food? Go.
Five Guys.
Oh, shit. We can include... Is there a Five Guys in Japan?
You bet there isn't.
Is there any more ham, Yuki?
Is there any more ham? Alright. He's left the room. He's just put a bread roll down in front of me. No context. No context at all. It's just a bread roll. With bread. In a bread roll. How does this... Am I pressing the right buttons? All right. Well, this is awkward. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for me to demonstrate my incredible Mario Kart skills. Skills that I have not deployed in the last 3 years. I'm winning. I'm winning already. 2, 1. Boom. Why aren't we...
That's backwards.
I was winning, you distracted me.
I did no such
thing. It's not easy having you in my ear shouting.
DG Medic beat you, and he's terrible. The arcade culture is actually excellent here. There are still tons of places you can go to arcades and play classic coin-ops, new coin-ops. My favorite one is in Akihabara. It's called Hey Hirose Entertainment. It's kind of hard to find. It's not hard to find. It's on the main street, but it's cleverly disguised. So that is my recommendation, but the arcade scene is still very respected and alive here. I recommend, if you're a fan of video games, this is the Mecca. It is the original place. It's the where they really came from. So I would recommend it for sure.
Don't eat the sandwiches.
Fine, I like
it. Well, I want it.
Oh.
What am I doing so badly? Because... I've definitely chosen the worst one.
No, it's not the choice. Don't a poor craftsman blames his tools.
Don't give me that shit. Come on, come on, come on, come,
come
on,
on,
come on,
oh.
Come on, come on. 10th,
okay,
yeah.
Okay.
We did it, we got to 10th place.
Let Chris know how he really did at Mario.
No, Connor and I are doing the series Wacky Weekend.
That's what it's called, the Wacky Weekend?
Chris and Connor's Wacky Weekend.
Two YouTube titans had time and they came up with Wacky Weekend?
Can I press anything? Will it destroy things? Or?
Yeah, don't press anything.
What's that?
That's the Benny Hill theme.
That's amazing. What is going on?
You're pushing buttons.
How do we stop this?
I'm pushing it.
Oh, God.
Now you're playing Guile. This is what I play when I'm trying
this is quality content.
Gotta get back to the
big face mode.
Big face mode. Well, it's supposed to be.
I'm not in a good mood now. Stop pressing buttons.
Oh wait, you can also push like these ones if you're like.
Alrighty.
You want to hear?
Nice shot.
What does this one do?
That brings you back to the main menu.
What's the bird do?
That goes to, don't push the bird! No, I'm kidding, goes to a different screen of like the Nintendo Switch. This is the, yep.
We just
alerts
did this all
are loud. I'm sorry. That's Chris playing the buttons. I don't have... I didn't know he'd be doing this.
Via Twitch. This is exactly...
LOL, I'm having a wank.
Via Twitch, this is exactly what it would be like every day.
This is what you'd just be doing? So did you guys have a good time tonight? I thought it was a great stream, one of the best we've had in some time.
IGN 6 out of 10.
IGN 6 out of 10. Not bad. Is Chris staying over?
You bet I'm not. Is this stream better than C-Dog VA's stream? Of course it is. Come on, look at this. You don't get this. You don't get this on C-Dog VA's Twitch. Apex Raid of Shadow Wank Legends. You get a guy in a chair with a hat. Pressing buttons on a stream deck. Fucking quality content. And it's a Tuesday. Cracking.
Thank you.
Twitch, innit?